हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन कोर्स ऑफ मैकेनिकल मेजरमेंट एंड मेट्रोलॉजी। माई सेल्फ अभिषेक त्रिवेदी फ्रॉम मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट एट एलजे इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। वी आर डिस्कसिंग द चैप्टर फोर्स, टॉर्क, प्रेशर, स्ट्रेन एंड टेम्परेचर मेजरमेंट। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव कवर्ड द बेसिक गेज फॉर द मेजरमेंट ऑफ द प्रेशर, दोज आर पिरानी गेज एंड मैक्लियोड प्रेशर गेज। वी हैव डिस्कस the basic constructional details of the Pirani gauge and the MacLeod gauge, as well as the working of the Pirani and the MacLeod gauge. Till now we have discussed, or we can say till now we have completed our topic of the force measurement, then torque measurement, then strain measurement and pressure measurement. In the force measurement we have discussed the different load cells. In the torque measurement we have discussed different dynamometers. In the particular pressure measurement we have discussed different gauge for the measurement of the pressures, and in the strain measurement we have discussed the strain gauges like mechanical, optical, electrical strain gauge, Rosset gauge, delta gauge and so on. Today we are going to start our new topic of the same chapter, temperature measurement. This is the last topic of the chapter, temperature measurement. Do remember, this is the very important chapter for your academic approach. First of all, let us understand the concept of the temperature, and then we are going to discuss the temperature measuring techniques, the different instruments available for the measurement of the temperature, the conventional instrument which is useful for measurement of the temperature, then the advanced instrument for the measurement of the temperature. Temperature measurement is a very wide range for the mechanical industries. We have to measure the temperature, let's say minus 40 degrees Celsius. We have to measure the temperature, let's say 4000 degrees Celsius. So we have very wide range for the measurement of the temperature, and as per the range of the temperature we have designed the different instruments for the measurement. So let us start with the very basic concept. What do you mean by temperature? So let us start with the concept of temperature. What do you mean by temperature? Temperature is the thermal state. Temperature is the thermal state, or we can say the thermal condition of the given body. We cannot measure the temperature by any of the instrument. Do remember one thing, temperature is a qualitative parameter which we have converted in the quantitative parameters. We can compare the temperatures with some reference. We cannot measure the absolute temperature. The concept of absolute temperature is null. We haven't any kind of absolute temperature concept. We can compare the temperature between the two bodies, and then we can justify that the particular body is hot compared to the other body, or the particular body is cold compared to other body. So temperature defines the thermal condition, or we can say the thermal state of the given body with the comparison to the some reference. So do remember, temperature is not an is a very absolute. So do remember that the measurement of the absolute temperature is nothing. We are supposed to compare the parameters. Also do remember, we cannot measure the temperature directly. We are supposed to measure the different physical quantities, and then we are calculating the value of the temperature in our defined unit systems. So we cannot measure the temperature directly. We are supposed to measure the different parameters, and from those parameters we are simply calculate the value of the temperature. The first one, that is we can say that the temperature of the substance is represent the thermal state of the given body, like hotness or the coldness. Let us consider the basic example. Let us take normal water which is coming from your tap. So the water which is coming from your tap, let's say having some sort of the temperature 25 degrees Celsius, with comparison to the ice. I'll place some sort of the ice over here having a temperature, let's say 0 degree Celsius. With comparison to the ice, if we are comparing these two particular, then this gonna be the hot and this gonna be the cold. But if I have the boiling water having, let's say, temperature range of 100 degree Celsius, then what does it shows? With comparison to the boiling water, this particular stands for the cold and this particular stands for the hot condition. So as I have told you that temperature is a reference parameter. With some sort of the reference, we are going to define the thermal condition of the given element. It is most widely used or measured quantity inside the process industries. Process industries contains all sort of the industries where the thermal condition is exist, where the thermal effect is exist, where some sort of the thermal effect will directly affect the main outcome of the product. We are supposed to measure the temperatures. The basic characteristics that can be used for the measurement of the temperature are change in the dimensions, change in the electrical resistance, change in the intensity, and the color of the radiation emitted. As I have told you that temperature cannot be measured directly. We have discussed that the temperature is a very absolute parameter. It cannot be measured directly. What we are supposed to do? We are simply measuring the different parameters, the different physical quantities, and then we are calculating the value of the temperature from those parameters, or we can say from the change of those parameters. Suppose the conventional thermometer, as you all know, aware about the conventional thermometer, which is useful for the measurement of the temperature of the human body. What does it contain? Suppose I'll draw a simple basic structure of the thermometer. Here we have different scales. Linear scale is there. Inside it, the mercury has been filled. Suppose I'll change the color of the mercury. Let's say we have the red color mercury. Mercury is filled inside this particular portion. So once the thermometer will make a physical contact with the human body, what does it shows? It shows the change in the height of the mercury. Let's say mercury will start rising in the upper direction till here. So what I am supposed to check? I know that I will simply check the opposite scale, and whatever the scale shows, I will define it. Let's say it's a 70. So I can say that the 70 degrees Celsius, that is the temperature of the given body. But actually, what I am supposed to check, I will simply check the height difference of the mercury. The mercury has started from this particular point and the mercury will ended over this particular point. So what I am supposed to check, I will simply measure the dimensions. I will simply measure the linear difference of the height of the mercury, and as per the linear difference of the height of the mercury, I will simply calculate the temperature. So I can say that for the measurement of the temperature, we are supposed to check the different parameters, different characteristics, the change in the different characteristics, like change in the dimensions. As I have told you that I will simply measure the particular change inside the height of the mercury, and then I will measure the temperature. Then the second one, that is the change in the electrical resistance. By checking the change in the electrical resistance, we can measure the temperature. The equation stands like R is equal to R0 1 plus alpha t plus beta t square. The equation shows the positive change of the resistance with the temperature. So what does it mean? Whatever resistance change is there, it will directly affect on the temperature of the body, where alpha and beta are the two different constants for the given material. T, that is the absolute temperature of the, or we can say the basic temperature of the given body, and R0, that is the resistance at the 0 degree Celsius. The resistance at the 0 degree Celsius. So by using this particular equation, you can measure the value of the R. Or if vice versa, if I know the value of the R resistance, then I can find the value of the T, I can find the value of the temperature. And to find this particular value of the R, we are supposed to use a very basic circuit, Wheaton bridge circuit. Wheaton bridge circuit is widely useful for checking, or we can say for finding the value of change in the resistance. Then we can also use the intensity and the color of the radiation which is emitted from the body. Suppose if the condition, or if the system will, if the system will cross the temperature range, let's say 500 degrees Celsius, let's say boiler is running with a temperature of, let's say, 1200 degrees Celsius. So there is no any chance, or there is no any condition that the human can access the boiler. If I have to measure the temperature, I have no any scope that I will simply lift, or I will simply put the thermometer inside the boiler and I will check the temperature. This is not the accessible, this is not the feasible condition for the measurement of the temperature. So in such condition, what we are supposed to do? We know that above the 500 degrees Celsius, द बॉडी इट्सेल्फ स्टार्ट एमिटिंग द रेडिएशन. द बॉडी विल इट्सेल्फ स्टार्ट एमिटिंग द रेडिएशन. सो वॉट आई एम सपोज टू डू, आई विल सिंपली चेक द वेवलेंथ एज वेल एज आई विल चेक द रेडिएशन कलर. ऑल्सो आई विल चेक द इंटेंसिटी ऑफ द कलर. सो बाय चेकिंग दिस पैरामीटर्स आई विल डिफाइन दैट द पर्टिकुलर रेडिएशन हैविंग सम सॉर्ट ऑफ द टेम्परेचर एंड द टेम्परेचर इज अप्रॉक्सीमेटली इक्वल टू दिस. Nowadays we have a lot of analytical approach for the measurement of the temperature and we can find the very precise temperature from the radiation. The one equation is useful for the measurement of the temperature, that is the one equation which is useful for measurement of such temperature from the radiation. The equation is Q, the heat which is coming out from the radiating body is equal to sigma B T para 4. The basic Stefan Boltzmann's law. The law says that whatever the heat which is coming out from the body is directly proportional to the temperature para 4. So if I know the value of the Q, sigma B, this is the value of the constant, Stefan Boltzmann's constant, I know the value of the sigma B, then if I will replace these two value, I can find the value of the temperature. So by using such equation, we can measure the temperature. Now temperature scales. We have defined a lot of scale for the measurement of the temperature. As we have discussed in the pressure measuring instrument, we have the different unit system for the measurement of the pressure. Same way, we have different unit system for the measurement of the temperature. The first scale, we can say the ideal scale, that is the centigrade or Celsius scale. For pure water, if the pure water freezes in the centigrade scale, it shows the zero value. Boiling condition of the water 100 degree Celsius and the absolute zero temperature -273 degree Celsius. The absolute zero condition will defined by the Kelvin. We can say that if the Kelvin achieves the zero value, I can say that it is the absolute zero condition. So if the Kelvin achieves the zero value, then the freezing point inside the Kelvin scale, that is a 273 Kelvin, and the boiling point inside the Kelvin scale, that is a 373 Kelvin. The next one, that is a Fahrenheit scale. The Fahrenheit scale is generally useful for the medical science. In the medical science, Fahrenheit scale is widely useful for the measurement of the temperature. Starting with the measurement of the temperature of the human bodies to the measurement of the species which is stored inside the medical physical laboratories, forensic labs. We have stored the so many species for the experiment, for checking the age, for checking the era of those particular species. We are simply using the Fahrenheit scale. In the Fahrenheit scale, the ice point of the water, that is a 32 Fahrenheit, the boiling point of the water, that is the 212 Fahrenheit, and the absolute zero condition stands for the -460 Fahrenheit. And the last one but not the least, that is the Rankine scale. Rankine scale also have the absolute zero condition, then the freezing point 492 and the boiling point stands for the 672 Rankine. So these are the basic scales which we are using as per the applications. All the scales are useful with a different unit system. The centigrade scale, or we can say Celsius scale, is widely useful for the day-to-day life. For measurement of the routine temperatures, we are using centigrade scale. Kelvin scale is useful when we are dealing with the higher side temperature. If we are dealing with the let's say 600 Kelvin or above it, then we are using the Kelvin scale, and it is also preferable scale for the measurement because Kelvin scale start with the absolute zero condition. So we are using the Kelvin scale, we are preferring the Kelvin scale for the measurement of higher temperatures. Fahrenheit, as I have discussed, that the Fahrenheit is very much useful for the medical science, and the Rankine scale is widely useful for the power plant. For all the vapor, for all the steam based power plant, we are using the Rankine scale for the measurement of the temperature. So as per the different applications, the scales are defined with a different unit system, and also all the scales are based, or we can say the basic reference for all the temperature scales are a pure water freezing condition and the pure water boiling condition. These two conditions are stands for the absolute reference condition for all the temperature scales. Now we are going to discuss the two basic elements for the measurement of the temperature. The first one, that is a bimetallic thermometer, और वी कैन से द सॉलिड एक्सपांशन थर्मोमीटर. द पर्टिकुलर बायोमेट्रिक थर्मोमीटर व्हाट वी हैव डन, वी हैव सपोज टू प्रोवाइड अ कैंटिलीवर बीम हैविंग द टू डिफरेंट मेटल. लेट्स से दिस इज द मेटल ए, दिस वन बी द मेटल बी. आई एम सिंपली प्रोवाइड द हीट बिलो इट. वंस द हीट विल बी स्टार्टेड हियर दिस इज द फिक्स एंड. सो देर माइट सम चांस दैट द होल सेटअप विल बी बैंड डाउन और वी कैन से द होल सेटअप विल बी राइजन अप. बट इफ आई विल प्रोवाइड द हायर थर्मल एक्सपांशन कोएफिशिएंट मटेरियल ऑन द बॉटम साइड इट विल डेफिनेटली बैंड डाउन एंड वॉट एवर द बैंडिंग विल बी जनरेटेड वी आर सिंपली मेजरिंग द एंगल ऑफ बैंड. We are simply measuring the radius of curvature of the band and from the analytical approach we can measure the change of the temperature. This is the bimetallic thermometer or we can say bimetallic expansion thermometer. Now what do you mean by low expansion coefficient and high expansion coefficient? Suppose I will change the temperature, let's say 10 degrees Celsius for both the material. If the material A, the length of the material A will change, let's say 2.5 mm, and if for the material B, let's say it's 3.5 mm, then I can say that for the unit change of the temperature, for the unit change of the temperature for both the material B will react very rapidly. The material B will react very rapidly, as well as we can say that the material B will shows some sort of the resistance quickly. So I can say that the material B is highly sensitive for change of the temperature as compared to change of the temperature of the material A. So we are going to select as a material B as a higher expansion coefficient and the material A having the lower expansion coefficient. This is the bimetallic thermometer or we can say the solid expansion thermometer. The next one, that is the liquid in glass thermometer. A very basic thermometer which we are conventionally used is known as the liquid in glass thermometer. The liquid in glass thermometer contains the bulb having the mercury. The liquid column is generated, the capillary tube is provided, and the linear scale is also there. Capillary tube is nothing but the glass tube having the diameter which is very small as compared to other tubes. Then it is known as a capillary tube. Due to the cohesive adhesive nature of the glass and the given liquid, the liquid will start rising in the upward direction. And once it will start rising in the upward direction, what we are supposed to check? We are simply check the linear difference between the height of the particular position of the given liquid. And then by checking the value of the height, we are simply find the value of the temperature by taking the basic reference as a particular height for the, let's say, what we are supposed to do. Suppose this is a scale. Let's say, the first height, that is the, let's say, 2 centimeter height for 0 degree Celsius. I will put the same in the boiling water. Let's say it will achieve the 5 centimeter height for, let's say, 100 degree Celsius. I can say that for changing the 100 degree Celsius, I supposed to require the 3 centimeter of height. If for any unknown temperature, if I will achieve the height, let's say 3.5 centimeter from the bottom line, I'll achieve the height, let's say 3.5 centimeter. Then I can say that in the 3.5 centimeter, 2 centimeter stand for the 0 degree Celsius, and the remaining 1.5 centimeter stands for the temperature which is risen from the 0 degree Celsius. I'll put the same over here for 1.5 centimeter. What is the change of temperature? So simply 1.5 into 100 divided by 3, this gonna 2, this gonna 50. So I can say that the temperature achieved, or we can say the temperature measured by the thermometer, is 50 degree Celsius. If the total height is 3.5 and if from the 0 degree it is 1.5 centimeter. So this is the basic concept of the thermometer. So what we are supposed to do, we are simply measure the temperature. And to measure the temperature, we are simply measure the height of the mercury. The figure shows the Celsius and the Fahrenheit thermometer which we are using for the humankind in the medical industries, medical science. So guys, over here we are going to wind up our lecture. What we have discussed, we have started with the concept of the temperature, how the temperature can be defined, what is the actual fundamental of the temperature. Then we have discussed the basic characteristics which we are going to measure, or we can say the change of those characteristics which we are going to measure for calculating the temperatures. Then we have discussed the different temperature scales, in which we have discussed the Rankine scale, Kelvin scale, Celsius scale and the Fahrenheit scale. Then at the end of the lecture we have discussed the two thermometers, the first one bimetallic or the solid expansion thermometer, and the second one that is the liquid in glass thermometer. These are the very basic instrument for the measurement of the temperature. From the next lecture we are going to start our next topic for the measurement of the temperature. We are going to discuss the thermocouple and the resistance temperature detector and the pyrometer in the upcoming lectures. Till then, thank you.